Hello and welcome to another episode of Speed, short, powerful episodes of enthusiasm and determination. Got a great little message for you today. I like it. I remember when I first read it, wow, I thought that is powerful. I've probably forgotten it since then, but it's been a great reminder to read the book again. Here we go. I was coming home from my father's house after dinner. He had given me lots of wonderful leftovers to bring home, as well as my old microwave oven, which he had borrowed, and a light fixture to try in place of a broken one in the house I had just moved into. It was late and I was tired. I looked at all the stuff in my trunk and thought, I can carry all this in one load. So I piled the fixture on top of the microwave, which was quite heavy but manageable for a short distance, and hung two bags of food on each wrist. Standing beside my car, I was quite proud of myself. Then I realized that I still had to close the trunk. Bringing one knee up to support the microwave, I freed the hand closest to the car to push down the trunk lid, but misjudged my ability to maneuver the weight of the bags hanging on my wrist. The lid came down quickly with a thud and latched. Sickeningly, I realized that my finger was still caught in it. As the pain began to register, I realized that I would have to drop the microwave in order to free myself. Standing on one leg, there was no elegant way to do this. The light fixture hit the ground with a crash and sprayed broken glass everywhere. It was like a scene from an old slapstick comedy. I couldn't have choreographed it better if I were Buster Keaton. Thankfully, my key fob with its button that opened the trunks was in my pocket. Otherwise, I could have been stuck there for a very long time. I managed to extricate myself, and my finger, although red and throbbing, was actually okay. The falling microwave had left a big white gouge in the side of my car and a hole in the front of my expensive new jeans. I felt incredibly stupid, busted for doing something so dumb, and I was mad at myself. What had made me think this was a good idea? Then I began to think, okay, this is ridiculous. What is the universe trying to teach me here? And some very wise words that I had heard from my friend Edward Brown, a Zen priest, came into my head. Carry one thing with two hands rather than two things with one hand. It couldn't have been more literally true, and I immediately saw was not working. I have done that a lot in my life, haven't you? Tried to carry too many things with one hand. Too many jobs, activities, relationships, worries, tasks. Carry one thing with two hands. Get your priorities sorted. Focus on it. Get it finished. Don't drop it. What a great message. I love it. Thank you for listening. I appreciate it. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.